The most common way to differentiate between different types of mining is to categorize them by what type of mining hardware is being used. So, we have CPU mining, which is done on computer processors, GPU mining, which is done on graphics cards, and ASIC mining, which is done on specialized purpose-built mining machines like this one, or this one, or this one. But what are the actual differences between these types of hardware for mining, and what advantages and disadvantages do they have, and which one is, you know, best? Well, that is what we're gonna cover in this video, because it goes a lot deeper than just price and profitability. Of course, there's also a lot of other categories in mining, like phone mining, FPGA mining, hotspot mining, hard drive mining, dashcam mining, and more. But they are all very niche, specialized, and sometimes inaccessible, so I won't cover those in this video, as they all kind of fall outside the umbrella of regular mining. But with that said, let's get right into it after a quick word from our sponsor. Coin Mining Central is an online store for ASIC miners, and there's no doubt that right now ASIC mining is by far looking like the most profitable type of mining, and the miners that I'm personally most interested in right now would probably be the Bitmain L7 and E9 Pro, as well as the Jazzminer X16Q. And what's cool about Coin Mining Central is that they always offer free worldwide express shipping, and I've always felt fully comfortable recommending them to you guys, and here's why. As opposed to most other ASIC vendors that are based overseas, Coin Mining Central is based and run out of England, Europe, where they have to adhere to the very strict regulations for customer support and personal detail protection that we have over here. And of course, all brand new miners come with a full manufacturer warranty as well. And because of this, Coin Mining Central has been a highly trusted ASIC miner store for miners like you and me for over 5 years at this point. They also care about this community, being very active and reachable on social media, and they've also provided loads of exclusive discount codes for you guys that you can use together with the link in the video description to save big on any miner that you want to get. And speaking of prices, I don't know if you've noticed, but ASIC prices have been dropping dramatically these past few months, so right now could be a very good time to stock up on some cheap hardware before the crypto market recovers, especially considering you get the already competitive pricing that Coin Mining Central has, plus the free worldwide shipping, plus the exclusive discount codes that I mentioned. So go check that out today. I'll have all of those discount codes and the exclusive link for you down in the video description. Let's start this video by talking about the actual physical differences between CPU, GPU, and ASIC mining. So, CPU mining just means mining on your computer's processor. And even dedicated CPU mining rigs are basically just stripped down computers with a very good CPU in them. GPU or graphics card mining is similar in that it's still done with one of the components in a regular PC. This time it's the graphics card instead of the CPU. And the same thing is true here, where dedicated GPU mining rigs are more or less just regular PCs with great graphics cards connected to them. But something that does set it apart from CPU mining is that with GPU mining, you can hook up many graphics cards to the same computer. It's actually fairly easy to build rigs with up to 12 graphics cards, all connected to the same PC. But in the end, both CPU and GPU mining is done with just regular consumer PC parts. ASIC mining, on the other hand, is different. Because an ASIC miner, short for Application Specific Integrated Circuit Miner, is a purpose-built machine just for crypto mining. They come in different shapes and sizes, from silent mini-box miners aimed at, you know, small home miners like us, to big, loud 3000-watt machines, and even higher-end water-cooled beasts for industrial settings. And that is what sets them apart on a physical, hardware-based level. Next, let's touch on how they differ functionally. And the main difference here is going to be versatility versus specialization. CPU and GPU mining have the advantage of being able to mine basically any mineable coin's algorithm, while ASIC miners usually can only mine one single algorithm, or in many cases even just one single coin. The advantage of the ASICs, however, is that since they are specialized and purpose-built, they can be extremely more powerful and energy efficient at mining that one algorithm or coin compared to GPUs and CPUs. But there is also a little bit more to it than that, because a lot of coins choose to go with what is called ASIC-resistant mining algorithms. And as the name suggests, that means that these coins aren't very well suited to build ASIC miners for, meaning they will, in theory, only ever be mineable with CPUs or GPUs. But broadly speaking, CPU and GPU mining rigs are able to switch between different coins and mine basically anything under the sun, while ASIC miners usually can only mine one single coin, but they are extremely good at mining that one coin. And usually if a coin has ASIC miners for it, that means GPU or CPU mining that coin is no longer an option, as those ASICs will be so much more powerful that it makes mining that coin on CPUs and GPUs unprofitable. A few notable examples for that are Bitcoin, Dogecoin, Litecoin, Caspa, Cadena, and Dash, that are all dominated by ASIC miners. Another thing to note here is the actual setup of the hardware, because ASIC miners usually only require a quick setup when you first receive the miner. Set it and forget it is what people usually say. GPU and CPU mining rigs, on the other hand, require you to install operating systems and mining software on the machine, as well as overclock and undervolt your hardware for better performance. But then, you might want to be switching what coins you are mining from time to time on those CPUs or GPUs. And of course, different coins require different mining software, as well as different overclock and undervolt settings for your equipment. So, CPU and GPU mining requires a lot more continuous attention, as opposed to ASIC mining. But now that we have a good understanding of the physical and functional differences between CPU, GPU, and ASIC mining rigs, I'm instead going to go through both the practical and theoretical pros and cons of them. Starting with resale value, meaning what happens if you want to sell your mining hardware later down the line, because this can be a bit tricky to wrap your head around at first. GPUs and CPUs are of course just regular consumer goods, so there is most likely always going to be a market to buy used computer components. For example, some dad might want to buy one of your old mining GPUs for a gaming PC he is building for his son, or someone might want to buy your CPU mining rig and use that as the base for a video editing computer. So, in a way, even if the hardware isn't able to mine profitably anymore, let's say because it's getting old and there are much better GPUs and CPUs for mining at that point, there should still be a second-hand market for selling your old mining CPUs and GPUs. With ASIC miners, on the other hand, if they aren't profitable to mine with anymore, then they are about as good as trash, and you're probably not going to get very much for them if you're even able to sell them at all. However, there is a whole other side to this, which is, what if the opposite happens, where instead mining profitability goes up for the hardware you have? Well, with CPUs and GPUs, we have seen before where high demand due to good mining profitability does drive up the resale price to maybe twice or even three times their recommended retail price, most notably when GPU mining was extremely profitable during the 2021 bull market. But ASIC miners, on the other hand, can increase in price by astronomical amounts. But not only that, they can also come back from the dead. For example, there was a time during 2019 where some unprofitable Dogecoin miners were selling for way under $50 each used on eBay. But of course, Dogecoin had a massive price increase in the 2021 bull market, making those same ASICs very profitable all of a sudden, and they were then selling for thousands of dollars each on eBay at that point. So while there most likely will always be some sort of secondhand market for CPUs and GPUs, the resale value of ASIC miners are very dependent on how profitable they are to mine on at that very moment. Of course, that could be both a blessing and a curse, because if your miner becomes super profitable, you might be able to sell it for many, many times the amount you originally bought it for, but if profitability goes down, you might struggle to be able to sell it at all. One thing I want to note here is to pay attention to the 4-year cycle that we've seen previously on the crypto market, where every 4 years we've had a massive bull market with new all-time high coin prices, followed by 3 years of low prices, before that whole cycle has started over once again. Because this cycle has also applied in a very similar way to mining hardware, where stuff is generally pretty cheap during the 3-year bear market, because low coin prices means poor mining profitability, so hardware is therefore cheap. But then during the bull market, coin prices go up, and so does mining profitability, and as a result, the price of mining equipment. And because of this, a lot of people actually buy mining hardware as a way of investing while prices are low, with the intention of reselling the equipment when prices go back up. Next, let's talk about some of the differences that affect mining profitability for these different types of mining hardware. With ASIC miners, you're kind of at the mercy of however profitable the coin your ASIC can mine is at any one moment. With CPU and GPU mining, however, You of course have the option of hopping on to mine whatever coin might be the most profitable at any given moment. The problem is that so does everyone else. And if a certain coin becomes profitable enough, basically anyone with a decent PC, let alone all the people with GPU and CPU mining rigs, can instantly start mining that coin, which would then completely decimate the mining profitability of that coin, and you're kind of back to square one. Because of that, with GPU and CPU mining, there is kind of this unknown vast amount of hash rate in the world that could just turn on at any moment on any coin. With ASIC miners, on the other hand, it's a bit easier to have some sort of idea of what is out there, because we know what ASICs there are for any specific coin, and how powerful and efficient those ASICs are. Of course, more hash rate comes online when ASIC coins increase in profitability too, but it usually happens at a much slower rate. The hash rate either has to come from new machines being produced, sold, shipped to the customer, and deployed, or it's old hardware that has been unprofitable because it was so inefficient, but has now become profitable again due to the overall mining profitability of the coin in question going up, for example, as a result of the coin price increasing. And in that case, if you were already mining profitably with your ASIC, then these older miners coming online again should be less efficient than yours, meaning you should still be profitable all else equal. And if profitability goes down again, they would have to turn their ASICs off before you, as they are less efficient than yours. I hope that all made sense. I also want to talk a bit about the natural progression of mining hardware. Usually how it goes is that when a new coin is introduced on the market, it is only able to be mined with CPUs or sometimes GPUs first. That is because when a coin is brand new, even if its mining algorithm is suitable for ASIC miners to be built for it, the fact is that there won't be any ASIC miners for it at that point, since, you know, they haven't been built yet. That means that one potential advantage of CPU and GPU mining is the fact that they allow you to mine coins when those coins are still brand new. Now, this is a bit of a generalization, because there are exceptions. For example, some coins choose to launch with old mining algorithms that there are already ASICs for. But more often than not, if you want to mine a coin very early on in its lifespan, which is usually when you can yield the most amount of coin, even with not very powerful hardware, then CPUs and GPUs are usually a better bet. The main reason people do this is to get a big amount of a coin early, with the hope that that coin will increase in price dramatically later on. Of course, the opposite can happen as well, where you hop on a brand new coin super early and it turns out that that coin was just a real dud and the coin price basically stays at zero the whole time and the coin just kind of dies and never goes anywhere and you wasted all of that power mining it. So let me summarize what we've learned so far. CPU and GPU mining are done with regular computer hardware, while ASIC mining is done with purpose-built mining machines. CPU and GPU mining rigs are a lot more versatile as they can mine basically any algorithm, but ASICs are way more powerful and efficient. And if there are ASICs for a certain coin, that usually means that CPUs and GPUs can no longer mine it profitably as they are so inefficient in comparison to those ASICs. Resale value is more steady for GPUs and CPUs, whereas ASICs can become both worthless or worth its weight in gold, depending on how profitable they are to mine with at the time you are trying to sell them. CPU and GPU mining rigs require a lot more work to set up initially, as well as a lot of constant reconfiguration if you want to keep it as profitable as possible by, you know, always mining the most profitable coin, while ASICs are just set it and forget it. GPUs and CPUs have the advantage of being able to hop on coins really early, which can be risky, but also has the potential to be a gold mine sometimes, while ASICs tend to have a more steady and predictable profitability in the long term, as long as you are paying attention to the landscape for mining that coin. Now, if you want to learn more about the theory of mining hardware, I have a video going through the core principles that come into play when choosing what CPUs, GPUs, or ASICs to buy for mining. I honestly think it's one of my best and most informative videos that I've ever done here on the channel. I'll link that on the screen over here. Below that will be another video about how to pick what coin to mine and some of the core concepts on how that works. So, I'll see you there. Thanks for watching.